So you want to edit a video from start to finish with your Insta360 footage, including multi-track editing, adding text and titles, transitions, effects, music, sound effects, and more. And you want to do it for free. While Insta360 Studio has just received a big update for multi-clip editing, it is still in its very early stages and can only achieve basic edits as of early 2024. So to celebrate the release of my brand new video editing masterclass, in this video, I'm going to share my entire workflow for editing your Insta360 shots completely for free inside of CapCut. And this process can be followed with any kind of video, whether you're using Insta360 footage or not. I know you're probably thinking that CapCut is a gimmick or an editor that is only for beginners, but I'm an experienced editor. I've been editing for over 20 years and I have edited all of my recent videos inside of CapCut, including this very video. And not only that, but I'm editing videos in half the time I used to take in Premiere Pro and the results are significantly better, especially for social media style videos where you don't want to overinvest time and money. So let's get started. So the first step in the editing workflow is reframing your footage. Unfortunately, CapCut isn't a reframing tool. However, Insta360 Studio is still free and you can still use it as a reframing tool to convert your 360 videos into flat 16:9 videos or whichever aspect ratio you prefer. This on average will take a few minutes per clip and is very easy to do through creating a keyframe, then moving along the timeline, changing the perspective and adding another keyframe. Then once you're happy, hit export and export at 4K H.265 with a bitrate of 100. And now we're ready for the real editing to begin. Now I will say that there are multiple programs you could use to edit these exported shots. Of course, there's all of the paid options like Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro, but then there's even better free options like DaVinci Resolve and CapCut. These are my two personal favorite video editors and I think each one does have a time and a place. DaVinci Resolve is more suited to advanced projects where you're doing a lot of editing of talking heads and you want to create your own customized graphics and do advanced color grading in the process, which makes it the best choice for more experienced editors working on bigger projects. Where CapCut is the better choice though is for beginner editors who want to edit really quickly through using drag and drop templates and really simple features that makes the overall editing workflow go so much faster. And this can also be really appealing for more experienced editors like me, which is why for any kind of video for social media, CapCut is my number one choice. Did I mention it's free? Yeah, I think I did. So here's how to edit with it. After downloading and installing CapCut from the CapCut website, which I'll link below, start a new project, and this is what the interface looks like. It's really very simple to use CapCut. So I'm going to start by selecting all of my video files that I've just reframed, and I'm going to drag and drop them over import here on the left. This has imported them into the project. You can adjust your project settings by clicking modify, where you can give it a name and adjust the resolution and frame rate. I'm going to customize mine to be 3840 by 2160, which is 4K. At 30 frames per second. Now I'll click save. To add a clip to the timeline, hover over it and click the blue plus icon. Here it is. So now we've got the option to trim this down even further. Maybe you want to cut the top and tail off of it. And I'm going to do so by pressing Q on the keyboard to delete everything to the left of the playhead. Then let's say I don't want anything beyond this point here. Now I'm going to press W and what that's going to do is remove everything to the right of the playhead. So you can go ahead and repeat the process with your other clips, add them onto the timeline. As you can see, we've got three clips here. So I'm going to repeat the process and might just get rid of a few frames at the start of this hyperlapse and a bit at the end as well by pressing W. I made a cool bike hyperlapse, but I can see it's got a few frames at the start that need to go. So I'll start it about here. So I'll press Q, go to the end and hit W. You may have a soundtrack attached to your clips. You can tell by whether there's waveforms or not. You can see this one on the left has waveforms and the other two don't. And these waveforms just represent wind noises. If I play, yeah, it's not very good. So to mute that, hover over the line that appears above the waveforms and you'll see this arrow shows up. Now click and drag that down to the bottom, and we've just muted our track. To add text to this video, head up to text at the top left click, and over default text, click the blue plus icon, and this will add a text layer to our timeline. Only text can exist on this layer, and only video files can exist on this one. Likewise, there's normally an audio track underneath the video one if you did record sound externally, or if you want to add music or sound effects, which we'll add in a bit. To edit text, click it, and then here at the top right, replace default text with the text you want to add. You can change the size, the font, there's heaps of fonts here to choose from. To reposition the text, click it here in the viewer and drag it, and you can also adjust these handles on the sides to make it bigger or smaller. Next, we want to animate this text, so it animates in and out. To do that, head up to animation, and we'll need to set the in animation and out animation separately. So CapCut has a massive library of transitions here. This is just a small portion of them, and I'm going to go with this one here, flip up, and as you can see here by this line, it's added this in transition to the text. So now what we want to do is add an out transition so it animates out. To do that, click out, and you can either find the same transition in here or choose a new transition to transition out. I've gone with the same one, which is flip in and flip out. This is what it looks like. Now you can reposition this text layer anywhere on the timeline by clicking and dragging. So if you wanted it at the very start of your video, you can do that. Then to extend it longer or shorter, just click the edge and drag. To add a transition in between two clips, so we're cutting from this shot here to this hyperlapse, head up to transitions at the top left, and here you'll find, again, a massive library of drag and drop transition templates. So take a look through here. To preview one, just click on it and it will apply to your edit. Add the closest edit point to where the playhead is. I quite like this rotate clockwise one. So what I'm going to do is click the blue plus and that will add it to the timeline if you click it. Now you can customize the length of it. So you can make it longer or shorter. Let's try this and see what it looks like. Nice. Then you can go ahead and repeat the process with all cut points. CapCut's also got a fantastic library of effects. If you click effects up here, it has literally thousands and thousands of effects. You can keep scrolling forever. And these are updated all the time. So that really is a big benefit of using CapCut, is it's constantly updated with drag and drop templates. You'll find categories for the different effects here on the left-hand side. I'm going to try the vlog effects. What about this one? Camcorder. Nice. To add an effect, click the plus button. Now you'll see it's created an effects layer. And just like with the text layer, you can drag it across, adjust the length. So by doing that, I've just applied this effect to this one single clip here, but not the second one. So if we watch it back, there we go. There's heaps of fun templates here, so definitely check them out. Right now, Insta360 Studio lacks the ability to color correct. Well, no problem, because CapCut has a great inbuilt color corrector. So if you select a clip and head up here to adjustment, here you'll find a whole bunch of parameters that will help us enhance these colors and make your video really pop. So I'm gonna do some quick color correction to this clip. Once you're done, if you click this adjustment box on and off, you can see your before and after. This is a good way to see how effective your color corrections are and whatever further changes they might need. Now you can do multi-track editing inside of CapCut. Here I imported the video of me talking from this video, and if I add that to the timeline, and if I click and drag these above it, suddenly I'm doing a multi-track edit where I'm using my Insta360 footage as the B-roll track. And you can really keep going with as many layers as you like that are either video, text, or effects. To add a music track to your edit, just click and drag onto your timeline and it will automatically be added. You can adjust the volume up and down the same way as before. And CapCut has a whole menu here of different ways that you can edit your sound, voiceover, sound effects to sound extra good. It's also got a decent library of inbuilt music and effects. So if I head here to sound effects, and let's say I want the sound of wind because I'm riding a bike through the wind. Here we have a library of sound effects we can use. To preview one, click it. Then to add one, as usual, click the blue plus. And as you can see, that's added a second audio layer to the timeline. And it's really as simple as that. Once you're happy with your video edit, head up to export at the top right, give your video a name, choose a save location, choose your export settings. I'd recommend copying these ones, then hit export. How easy was that? That video edit took literally minutes compared to what would have been hours in other programs, which is why I recommend that even if you are a more experienced editor, try CapCut and see if you like it, because at the end of the day, one problem that all video editors face is workflow time. Anytime you can reduce your workflow time or even cut it in half, you get all of that time back to work on more important things like new edits, new projects, or the more creative aspects of making videos. And it really does have a wide range of intermediate to advanced templates that make adding graphics to your videos a breeze. Also, why pay for costly software subscriptions when you don't have to? And I've really only scratched the surface here of what CapCut can do. Inside my new CapCut editing masterclass, I cover it in much more depth, including every single feature of the software and how you can use it to become a confident and speedy video editor in just one day, regardless of your current experience level. You can learn more about the course by following the link below. Now, I do want to touch quickly on the immersive side of 360 video editing. While most people use Insta360 cameras to reframe footage to a flat 16:9 perspective, there are some people that want to edit their 360 videos to be viewed immersively in VR. Well, unfortunately, the free options here are a bit limiting. With both CapCut and the free version of DaVinci Resolve, you can edit 2:1 equirectangular videos, but only up to 4K resolution. So if you're shooting in 5.7K or 8K, then you're going to have to downscale your footage, which obviously isn't ideal. So the software I would recommend for VR editors is either Final Cut Pro, which is a great beginner software for Apple users, or DaVinci Resolve Studio, which is a great investment and allows you to export as high resolution as you like and has a ton of VR compatible plugins. If you have decided to use CapCut, then also feel free to join the brand new Facebook group I started, which is a great place to interact with other CapCut users and get your questions answered. So I'll link that down below. CapCut does also have a mobile app. However, I would always recommend editing on desktop over mobile, since your export quality is always going to be far greater and the actual editing experience is much easier when you're working with a mouse and a keyboard and a big screen compared to a tiny screen and having to swipe around with your fingers. However, the mobile app is still good for quick and simple edits. Now, if you want to see the end result of an entire YouTube video that I edited 100% inside of CapCut using reframed Insta360 footage, then check out this video here. In it, you'll learn how to achieve 10 epic effects with your Insta360 camera. So this is one you definitely won't want to miss.